Welcome to Programming with Qt Widgets. If you're into a code kata, maybe you should hang on, because I'll implement something as trivial, which turns out to be somewhat hard, namely a push button with a signal for double click. So I wanted to record an episode on signal throttling, and I thought, hey, I'll create a push button just for example, whatever. And it turned out this is not going to be about signal throttling. So you'll have to wait a few weeks for that episode. But what I'm going to show here is actually implementing something as simple as a push button with double click signal being emitted whenever it's double clicked, which push button do not have. And it's actually answering a question that came up a year ago on the channel, asking how do I handle double click without handling single click first. And for that, let me just show you what I need. I need this one. I hope that post-production managed to put in something that looks like a crystal ball, because obviously you cannot emit double click without first emitting single click, because how would Qt know that the single click should not be emitted because a double click will come sometime in the future? But you can, of course, postpone sending out that single click until you notice that, well, timeout for the double click. And that's what I wanted to implement. So let's see the first attempt at that. It will be shown in 5 parts, this solution here. Part number one, first attempt, double click button. You can see I connect to clicked signal, thanks, and to double clicked, which is not a methods or not a signal of QPushButton itself that says, hey, not so fast. And let's see what my double click button look like. Well, it subclasses from QPushButton because it's almost like a QPushButton. It implements this mouse double click event and it emits a signal. And that's what we see here. There really is not much to it. Whenever I get the mouse double click event in, I'll emit the double click signal. And as you can see, click here, thank you, thank you. But that's a problem. There was this thanks that should have not come out, because that's the feature that I'm looking for. So step number two. So it's time for us to get the crystal ball out. When I click, I need to know whether there's going to be a double click in the future. Obviously, a crystal ball doesn't exist, at least I haven't seen one. But what I can do is that I could postpone sending out that click signal until I have seen the double click, and or seen that there is no double click, rather. How do I do that? Well, I do it like this. A simple QTimer single shot to say that, hey, don't go off every whatever. And how often should it go off? Well, Q application double click interval tells me how long between 2 clicks for them to be considered a double click. My timer goes off, emits the click signal, my mouse release event is pressing or starting the timer, and my double click is stopping it. And unless it gets to the double click here, it will eventually fire and I'll be emitting the click. I do not call the superclass, because if I did, then that's exactly where the emit click signal is located, and then it would go off right away, which is what I do not want. Click, click, and thank you. Click, and thank you. Double click, and no, thank you. Well, that was a thank you coming after, but we'll look at that a bit shortly. But let's see another problem here now. If you look at the button, I click, see, it's stuck down. My fingers are up here. I am not keeping the mouse button down. And what's the problem? The problem, of course, is that when I release the mouse button, I do not call the superclass, namely the QPushButton's release event, and that's where it will take care of drawing itself in the upstate again. So I need to call that one, but I need to make sure that it do not emit the signal. Obviously, I could take the implementation of the push button and of its mouse release event and just take it down here. But there is another way. Let me show you. Again, my timer is set up just as before. My mouse release event, this time it calls mouse release event of the superclass. But to avoid that superclass emits the signals, I am creating this QSignalBlocker, and the QSignalBlocker is blocking on this, which means that as long as this one is in existence, it will not block any signal. And QSignalBlocker is just this pointer block signal, and then at the end, this pointer, well, block signal false at the end. It's in this QSignalBlocker RAII class, which is very handy. Dangerous? Yes, I admit, there could have been signals in there that somebody was relying on, say, a released signal, which I don't think there is, but there could have been. So careful with that class, but useful in our situation. Shall we try? Pressing down, releasing, looking good. Pressing down, releasing, looking good. Double click, and still this thanks is being emitted. Let's look at why that is now. So to investigate that, I've changed my application slightly so that it prints out in all of the methods when I'm there so I can get some more insight. So mouse press event, press, mouse release event, release, and double press and double click, whatever it should have been called, and here's my signal. So let's try and run that and click, press, release my signal. That's cool. That's as it should be. Okay. Double click, press, release, double press, press, release. Why didn't it say press, release, and then double press? And then my signal, that's peculiar. Let's go. And obviously I did this before the example here, but what I did, let me just put it that way, is that I wanted to look at the mouse press, who emitted that. So I'll put a breakpoint here. I'll start the debugger. And the reason why I set a breakpoint there is because that otherwise I'll never get to double click because the first click will hit up there. Double click. And there's my breakpoint, and go up here now. I continue. Now I would like to know how that was called. So I look here in my backtrace. I'm in double click button, mouse press event, go up, mouse but down here, Q push button, mouse double click. But that, wait. So Q push button, mouse double click event is calling. See, that's the kind of thing that makes me lose all faith in humanity and trust in debuggers. There must be a frame in between here. Let's look at what mouse double click event on Q push button looks like. Got any idea? Well, obviously it doesn't have anything like that. But fortunately, come on. I cannot go to the implementation of this right now. Could just a second ago. I'll go and find it myself if that's what required. Is that good enough now? It goes and calls this one. I don't know why that stack frame was not in the backtrace, but Q double click. Nah, come on. Q double click button for mouse click event called mouse double click event, which called the widgets implementation of this. And the reason for that, at least as well as I can figure it out, is that while a double click to me seems like a total event on its own, it is actually just from the underlying system yet another mouse press, and Qt will only send one event at least far down through the system for that, and then it will pick it up itself and say, okay, let me also give you a mouse press event in case that you didn't listen to a double click. Of course, no mouse press event on its own will be sent. It's just a mouse press with a flag saying, hey, this was actually a double click. Oh, Jesper. You got yourself into trouble here yourself, and now you're blaming Qt for weird behavior. If we look at the code a bit more again, mouse double click event, you call the mouse double click event of the superclass here, and that is the one that then says, okay, if you haven't implemented a mouse double click event, then you likely just want a bunch of click events. So why don't you do as you just did there now, comment out, don't call that super, and then mouse click event will never be called. Okay, let's try that. Click. Well, that was not the use case that was interesting. Over here again, double click. press release, double press. No, you're right. There are no press being called, but release is still being called. And that's the crucial one, because it's in the release signal or the release part that the signal is being pressed. So this is not the right solution to that problem. What is the right solution? Well, as hacky as it sounds, the only solution I at least can see is that I'll block the signal from the release that comes out after a double click. And it looks like this. In the release here, I'll check whether I'm actually in block next release. Well, let's go and look at the block next release. Mouse double click. So when I've seen that, then I will stop the timer, meaning, okay, so no emitting the signal from the first one we saw. And I will set this flag saying block next release. And my block next release up here, if I have that set, then I will not call the start. And then I'll set it to false. That way, when my first press and release come in, it will start the timer, everything's cool. And if a second one come in before the timeout, then the double click will be called. I will stop the timer, which blocks the signals from the first one. I'll set this flag, which when the next press and release comes in, I'll block the signals for the release there. I could, of course, have blocked the complete press and release. I could have not called the press by not calling the QPushButton mouse double click. Actually, I turned out not to do that, but the release still needs to be blocked, and that's why I do here. I could, of course, have implemented a push button all myself, and if I had a widget all of my own where I wanted to implement double click, then I would likely have been in much less trouble than I was here. Would I have chosen this solution in my own code base? Yeah, likely. Of course, either I would have to do it like this, or I would have to go and look very careful in the implementation of QPushButton and more or less copy all the code out of there to make sure that it would still behave correctly in all the corner cases. And just in case that you're wondering, let's just finally just go to QPushButton.cpp and find the mouse press. Not here, huh? Where is it then? Q abstract push button. Abstract button. Q abstract button. I'm almost there. And here is my Q abstract button. Mouse press event. Not entirely trivial. Mouse release event. Not entirely trivial. And would I want to copy all that out? Just for the case that the next version of Qt had some minor changes in here that I would break. I have not a good solution to this, but at least you've seen a solution now. So thank you very much. Okay, that's it for this episode of Qt Widgets and More. If you want to learn more, then of course there is what? More than 115 episodes by now of Qt Widgets and More. But if you want to learn it from scratch, from the bottom up, then we are currently releasing Programming with Qt Widgets, whole training on Qt Widgets. And I don't know how far we made it in the release of that when you watch this, but at least two or three modules have been released by now. That should give you a good start on Qt Widget programming. Until next time, remember, have a great time.